Good afternoon, and welcome to this ClusterAct webinar. And I'm really glad to introduce the webinar today, that is Insight on Pitching. So how should I pitch? And we will talk about a company's pitch presentation with an insight that will be provided by Francesca Natali. So, and actually, I would like just to introduce you, Francesca, that is from MetaVentures, and she will be with us, and she will hold the webinar today. A reminder that the webinar is organized within the ClusterAct project, that is a project funded under the ASME EMMF, and is focused on the increasing and stimulating connection between investors and SMEs in the maritime sectors. With this regard, the pitching is becoming even more important in the latest developments. And we believe even for the enterprises, it's becoming really important to understand what are the tools and the advices to perform a good pitch. So good afternoon, Francesca.
And, thank you.
Welcome. We hear you really well. And now I think we will be able to start really soon with your presentation, just to fix some logistics.
Yeah. Perfect. So, good evening, everybody. And thank you for being with me, with us this afternoon. Thank you, Carlo, and thank you to the project for having invited me as an expert to deliver the speech this afternoon. And maybe I would like to start saying a few words about myself. I don't know if you can see my screen right now. Can you?
Actually, we can see your screen, and okay, we can see that it's not in, okay, now it's perfect. It's like in a presentation.
Okay, great. Okay, so the reason why I've been invited for this speech is because I am a fund manager, meaning that I'm in charge of the management of a number of venture capital funds investing into early stage companies. It means that in the last, let's say, 15 years, I've been listened to a number of pitches delivered by a huge number of companies. It means that I have an in-depth experience about pitches and about mistakes that companies often do when they do deliver a pitch. Last but not least, I was in Brussels a couple of weeks ago, listening to pitches delivered by companies that have been invited in Brussels for presenting their project as a second step for the AC Accelerator, which is the new program from the European Commission, which replace SME instruments, phase two. So I would like to devote at the end of my presentation to saying few words about the pitches that companies that are selected are invited to do in Brussels, because I believe that it could be quite interesting for you, being a new program and being a new way to select company, both for grant and for equity. So let's start, and let's start about telling few words about what is a presentation. A presentation, it is a story, and you should present your story. What is your story? It means why you are pitching. There are different reasons why you may pitch. you may pitch in front of investors, meaning that you are looking for money, and this is the reason why you are delivering your pitch. But there are different type of pitch, meaning that maybe you are looking for clients or you are looking for partnership. So you should have clear in mind the reason why you are pitching, because according to the reason why you are pitching, you should shape your presentation. During the pitch, you need to cover a number of points. You should present your team, you should present your business model, you should present your marketing plan, you should present your financials. But you have time constraint, meaning that you are not running a marathon, but you are running 100 meters. Remember that when you are pitching, you have as average between 3 up to 10 minutes to cover a number of points. That's why you are not running a marathon, but you are running 100 meters. So the most important point when you are pitching, doesn't matter why you are pitching, is you to leave an impression. Leave an impression means that you must be remembered, because when you are pitching, of course, for a precise goal, for a precise target, money, clients, and whatever, but the pitch should allow you to reach a second stage, meaning a second meeting with the investor, with the client, for better presenting you, for better presenting your product, and better explain the technology behind your product or behind your service. It means that it is a communication exercise. So you should use all your best communication skill in order to encourage someone to do something. Here I'm using the Winston Churchill example, because Winston Churchill has been capable to convince a British person to enter into the war at the moment when the country was really very weak, but also thanks to his communication skill, Winston Churchill was able to convince a British to enter into wars. When you deliver a pitch, is most based on visual communication. Remember, visual information are 60,000 times faster than text. Remember, so try to avoid to use slide with too many words. The visual language is much more effective than the written language. I remember that once we decide to enter into the due diligence process, only when we saw, a presentation based on pictures before the treatment and after the treatment. The pictures were so impressive that we decided to move forward in our due diligence process only because, or mainly because, those pictures. So remember that visual communication is more effective, is faster, and more impressive.
It's fine, yes, perfect.
Okay. So as my first suggestion is do not enter into details when you are pitching. Keep it high level, keep it clean, meaning that you shouldn't enter into technical or scientific details. And it is a mistake that often professor or scientific scientist do. So remember, don't draw into details. Why it's not? Okay. You should do it in a fast way, because remember the time constraint. You have 3, 5, 7 minutes as a maximum. So you should be able to deliver a fast speech in a engaging and a simple way. Try to transfer the message you want to pass across in a fast and simple way. You should underline the messages you want to to deliver to your audience. So at the end, what is a presentation? A presentation, it's a number of slides, a simple slide, slides that are written in a simple and understandable way, that are presented in a fascinating and smart way. So at the end, a presentation is the way you are telling your story in 10 and no more great slides. So if we jump into the content of those 10 great slides, you should remember again that the message that you are passing, that you are that you are giving, should be keep it in a simple and captivating way. Pitching is about grabbing the attention of the audience, and the first line of your presentation is really crucial. It needs to be exciting, funny, confusing, or whatever you think benefits your pitch the most. So you should start from presenting, from describing the problem. And bigger the pain, the better. You should make them feel the pain. What does it mean? It means that the problem is the most important asset you have. So it's imperative to make the investor feel the pain point. Why is an important problem to solve, and how does it affect the end user? You need to explain in a very clear way. One great technique, as I said, is the storytelling. And you may call from your personal experience. Keep it punchy, keep it visual, and always keep in mind the point of view of the end user. It makes sense to engage the investor to do so. Ask them how often they have experienced the problem you are solving. But do not overload your audience with information. Just make sure that they feel how terrible is the problem that you are solving. And the fact that you are currently solving the problem in the most effective way. So, remember, the problem always comes before the solution. So you should always start in presenting the big problem your solution, meaning your service, meaning your product, is solving. A number of startups, unfortunately, are created on temporary market, meaning that they are not solving true problems. That's why the problem is really, I mean, your starting point. After presenting and having introduced the problem, you should jump into the solution. Here you should describe how your product is going to improve the world by fixing the problem. How does the world look after your solution will be implemented? Is everyone happy to use your solution? Kids, remember, here at this stage, many entrepreneurs failed in entering into technical details. Remember, you should keep it clean. Do not overload the investor with too many scientific or technical information. Why you shouldn't do that? Because your audience, the investors that are in front of you, maybe do not have the technical or the scientific background to understand what you are saying. You will have time later on, maybe in the next meeting, to enter into a technical due diligence with investor. At that stage, you should keep it visual and simple. If you have a great design-based product, here is the moment to show. If you have a demo, you should use it, but make sure that the demo will work. Here, your mission is to make the audience understand why your product or your service solves the problem far better than anybody else. After having covered the solution, then you should go into the market. Keep in mind what venture capitalist is thinking. Is this market big enough for the investment that I'm keen to do? Because sites at the end are very important. So at this stage, at this moment, you should prove that you know your market, you know your clients, you know where they are, how many they are. You should know that your market is growing fast. If there are changes in the market that are creating room for your invention. Here you should prove that you are capable to enter into the market and you have the capability to scale. Sometimes a mistake here is that few entrepreneurs make confusion about clients and end user. It means that the end users are the beneficiary of your service or your product, but sometimes they are not the ones that will pay for your product or for your service. So be aware about the difference between clients and end users or beneficiaries. So for you, what is relevant is to know where the clients are. Especially for the biotech or the medtech sector, it makes a big difference. So please do not make any confusion when you are measuring your market between clients, which is the numbers that is relevant for you, and end user. I would like to say something more about the market, which is, I mean, a very important part of the pitch, especially for young and startup companies. Here, in the market part of your presentation, you have to describe the opportunity you have to create revenues and margin by disrupting the existing industry. Here it's very common to use TAM and SAM, mean the total addressable market, versus serviceable available market. I don't know if you are familiar with those numbers, but the TAM is the total market for your product. This is everyone in the world who could buy your product, regardless the competition in the market. The sum is the serviceable available market, meaning the portion of your market that you can acquire. So, I mean, those sum and TAM are numbers that can or must be used in order to present, in order to show and to measure the market you are keen to enter. So, at the end, here you should show that the market is interesting for investors. Why? Because at the end we are looking for sizable return on our investment. So here you should show us the potentiality of your business. After presenting, described in a clear and simple way the market and your capability to scale, you should jump into the business model part. Here again, it's sometimes, a tough point for a few entrepreneurs because they present a number of business models that are sometimes in conflict one each other. What is the business model? It is a simple concept at the end. It's how and when you, together with the investor that will put the money in your business, will be rich. At that stage, meaning at the business model part of your presentation, you should describe the revenue sources. For being more precise, here, is the point where you have to convince the investors that you are capable to make money out of the business you are presenting. You should say, you should describe if you are using recurring revenues or one-time payment for the product or the service you are presenting, fixed pricing or dynamic pricing. Again, this is one of the most important points for the investor. Don't show them 50 different types of way you can make money out of your business. Focus on the most profitable one. Make it work and then you may, and then, in, I mean, be sure that it works. The audience, the investors want to hear how you intend to earn money from your solution. It is a very important part. Sometimes it is very confusing, but for the investor it's crucial to understand how you want to make money out of your business. Here, it's a very old-fashioned type of business model, but it explains in a simple and clear way how a business model for a telephone company could be. It is a way to show that you have a clear way how you intend to make money out of the business you are presenting. Investors will expect to see financials out of the business model you are presenting. Sales forecast, income statement, profit and loss, and cash flow forecast, which are of course linked to the business model you are presenting. On the financial part, remember to be realistic, but not too conservative. Investors see a hockey-stick projection at this time, meaning that they will cut your projection in half. You can explain your growth based on traction you already have or compare to a similar company in a related industry, which is very useful for an investor point of view. What's more about the business model? Well, maybe if I was not clear enough, you can come to me later on with the request of clarification or request for example, if it may be the case. After presenting the business model and having presented the financials related to the business model you want to implement it, then it's time for you to show why you are the first or at least the better in the market you want to enter. It will lead you to describe and to present your unique value proposition. That moment of your pitch, of your presentation, you should say if you have IP rights, if you have CE certification, if you have US certification on your product, because are relevant information that can give you an added value. Here you should explain how the company is protecting the technology, who else may have legal rights on your technology. Here you should be prepared in discuss patent ownership if it come up. It is an important point, especially for a certain type of businesses. It is more important, for example, for biotech and medtech related businesses rather than ICT-based business. Why it's important to show if you may have it's important to show that you have a patent or a number of patents. Easy, because investors like a lot unfair advantages. And if you have an IP right, or if you have more than one IP right, it will give you an unfair advantages on your competitors. Of course, you should be able to prove that you have a solid and a crystal clear IP rights on your product or on your technology. So declare here your patents or any other ownership right that you may have on your product, on your technology. After having described your IP rights, you should be able to go straight to the competitors part of your presentation. Competition, what does it mean? So what you should do it here? Here you should express, you should say how are you solving the problem in a different way. Be realistic and do not know the competitors. Investors don't want to hear you criticize the competitors, but we like to understand why you are performing better than your competitors. We want to know who your competitors are. We want to see names on the matrix you will prepare and present. Why you are better, and please never say that you have no competitors, even if you believe it. After having described your competitors and why you are better, you may present your unique value proposition. What does it mean? It is, again, a very simple and compelling message that you should be able to deliver to your audience. What is it? It is the value, the real value that could be qualitative or quantitative, that you are transferring to the clients when they buy your product, when they buy your solution. There are different types of transfer that you may transfer to your clients. Novelty, price, design, risk reduction. So you should explain and you should prepare a simple and compelling message that should be understandable to the investors, to your audience, in a very fast way. After having presented your unique value proposition, you should go to the marketing plan part of your presentation. You already described your market and you already have presented through numbers the famous sum and thumb indication where and how much how many your clients are. But here is the moment to say, how do you get your customers? Do not underestimate the importance to explain again in a simple way how do you intend to get your customers. Why it's important? Because you have to capture a new user. And here you have to show that you have the capability to execute your business. What marketing channel at the end you will use? How you will apply this model when you will enter into new market? Having a poor acquisition model is where many startups fail. So knowing your market strategy is crucial when you meet investors. So again, do not underestimate the marketing plan and to explain how do you intend to reach your customers. If I go back to my experience, I have seen, unfortunately, a number of startup fails because they weren't able to get the customer, to enter into the market, because they didn't have, a clear vision on how to acquire customer, even if those company in most of the cases had a great and innovative product. Sometimes it's because the entrepreneur has not the capability, the skill to acquire clients. Sometimes it's because the entrepreneur is not willing to recruit staff with adequate skill for selling the product. But at the end, the results is the same if you do not implement the proper marketing plan. The company will fail because the company, the product will not reach the market. So it's very important for the investors to understand that you have a clear plan to acquire customer. After having covered the marketing plan, it's time for you to present your team. How is the, who is your team? Here is the moment to present the key person in your team. An idea is nothing without an execution. What relevant experience and skill does your team bring to the table? Here is the moment to show and to explain to the investors. For investors, especially for investors that are keen to invest at the very early stage moment, it's very relevant to have in front of them a great team. Because having a great team will ensure, will ensure the possibility for the company to bring the product into the market. If your team is young and doesn't have much or any experience in the sector, then you should focus on pertinent points and look for other strengths that you may have. Don't shy away from that topic because you lack industry experience. Because sometimes the best team are built on new team. So even if you are a new, a virgin team, you may be appealing enough for investors. You should declare the fact that it is a new team, that you may lack some skill or expertise, but you are in the process to recruit extra members for your team in order to fill the gap in your team. At that stage, you should explain why you and your team are the right people to build and to grow the company. What experience you have that the others don't. Here is the moment to explain and to convince the investors that you are the right team to support. Here you should also present your advisory board if you have it, because it's something nice to have, especially if you are not a so young company. It's nice to see that the company has an advisory or a scientific board. You may also present the board of director if you have an experience board. So after presenting the team, is the moment to go to the final part to your presentation, which is, let's say, the call for action. Is the moment where you should declare what you are looking for. You should do it saying if you have already raised money in advance, when the money already raised come from. Here you should indicate how much money are you looking for and how you will spend the money, and if you have an exit plan, you should present again to show an exit plan, even if you are a new and just established company. It's something nice, it's something that investor will appreciate. Why? Because investor, risk capital investor, play the game to invest into the company, like your company, is because they want to leave your company at certain moment. That's why it's important, it's nice, it is appreciable, you to show you have thought an exit plan. Of course, the exit plan will be, not so detailed, but you may present to the investors option that could be that could be used as a possible way to leave the company after a certain reasonable time. So it's always to see an exit option is always something that investors appreciate. So I invite you to think about it and to show in your pitch and your presentation exit option. Just to make a very sum up of what I said, remember your pitch should be based on 10, 12 as a maximum slide. Few information into the slide. Try to use pics or images rather than too many words. Do not enter into many details. Try to give it a clean. Try to give it simple. So my suggestion is to use a person from your team that have a good communication skill in order to you to have a smart and an appealing presentation. Because remember, at the end, you should be remembered. It means that you should leave an impression on the investors, on the audience, in front of the on the person that are in front of you and that are listening to a number of pitches. So remember that for you, at the end, the most relevant goal is to leave an impression, because this is, the most, because this is the way you may have the chance to get a second meeting for a more detailed and for a longer meeting with the investor. It's not only about slide and and pics on the slide. It's also about body language. It is about the way you will be able to engage, physically engage with the person that are in front of you and that are listening to you. You should avoid slow start. That's why it's so important to start in the proper way. Try not to speak too fast. Use pauses and respect time. Again, keep it clean, keep it simple. Last message is you should practice, because at the end it's question of exercise, exercise, exercise. And if I may suggest you a couple of nice videos, I mean, you may find here the YouTube address. Are those two short videos, and I invite you to apply the 10, 20, 30 rule presented by Guy Kawasaki. The 10, 20, 30 rule, it's a simple rules for delivering a nice presentation. That means 10 slides, 20 minutes and 30 as a size of the font you should use into your slide. I invite you to watch to those two videos. The first one will the first video proves that it is possible to deliver a very effective and comprehensive pitch in 3 minutes. So I always been asked that 10 minutes is not enough to cover all the relevant points that you should cover while you are presenting, but believe me, it is possible to go through a team, financial business model, and so on and so forth in 3 minutes. And if you go to the video, you will see. If I have time, I have a couple of minutes left. I like Carlo, if I may.
Yes, please.
As I promised, because I mean the EC Accelerator, it's a new program from the European Commission that could be interesting for you. And because I've been, I mean, a couple of weeks ago in Brussels to listen to a number of pitches. Unfortunately, none of those were from Italian companies. And me and the other jury members were asked to select companies both for grant and blended finance. As you may know, the program has changed. The SMEs instrument phase 1 and 2, now it's called AC Accelerator. And if you are selected for the phase 2, you will go in front of 6 jury members in Brussels, and the company will be asked to make a presentation, like a Dragon Den presentation. So the company will have 10 minutes to present the project, and then the company will have 30 minutes to reply to a number of questions that will come from the jury member. So what I have learned and from my experience in Brussels is the fact that you should be that the level is very high. It is a very competitive environment, and the company should come to Brussels really prepared. The program will invest both through grant and equity into high risk, high grow, not bankable company. What does it mean? There are 3 key elements that should come up after your pitch in Brussels. You should convince the jury member that you are a high grow company, high risk and that you were not capable to raise money among the financial community. That's why you are asking to the European Commission money to finance your great product, your great technology. So for proving that you are a high risk and high growth company, you should prove to your to the jury member that you have a great market in front of you, that you know your market and you are keen to scale the market, and you know how to do it. So it is really a very important point. Another important point for me, another a suggestion that I would like to give you is not to be too conservative, because when you are showing number, when you are declaring your vision and your ambition about the future of your company, because again the selected company are high growth companies. So show ambitious number and show that you have the right team, well balanced in terms of scientific and sales skills. Because only a well-balanced team could convince the jury member that the company has the capability to scale the market. On the slide, you may read more relevant point that you should take in mind if you are thinking to apply to the program, which I believe is a great opportunity if you are if you have the physique du role to apply. I believe that it is a great opportunity because a company now can apply not only for grant but also for equity, and they could ask up to 15 million euros, which is really, a great ticket for company that want to scale the market. And because the Italian company are not performing so well, at least in the last call it was like this, I believe that there is room, there is space for the Italian company to improve their rate success into the program. So I invite you to have a look to the website, and maybe if you like, you can also come back to me, to Carlo, in order me to provide you with more information and tips about it. I think that so it's five. The time management has been quite quite good. I would like to thank you for sharing your time with me, and if you have question, I am here, more than happy to provide you with explanation and clarification if it may be the case.
Yes, thank you. Thank you very much, Francesca. Yes, timing was perfect, and actually maybe we can take just few minutes to see if there is any curiosity or question from the audience, actually, that we can we can also dedicate a few minutes now, but as said before, at the same time also the applications, the application GoToWebinar allows us to collect if there are curiosity for questions later on. And but at this moment we haven't received questions until now. They can confirm me. And maybe it's one curiosity from my side. We can notice that in the latest time it's really becoming frequent to be asked like video pitch deck. It's it's true. So actually, video pitch deck is a new tool that is somehow comparable to the real time pitch. So I don't know if there is any specific.
Video pitch is nice for if you are a remote evaluator. I mean, rather than receive a pitch deck, maybe it's better to see a video when the entrepreneur present himself or herself the deck. So I prefer, I mean, a video rather than going through, I mean, 10 or up to 12 slides. But of course, I mean, after the pitch session, it's always nice to have the entrepreneur in front of you in order to ask for clarification and for, going through few uncovered points. But okay, I mean, it's a more, having a video rather than a pitch deck, it's of course more lively and more, it's nicer at the end.
Okay, thank you very much.